What's up, YouTube? We are going to release our top picks for the MVPs at each position at the mid-year mark for the AAF season. We will start off with defense, move on to special teams, and end with offense. Make sure to like, subscribe, and comment who you think should be on this list. Let's begin this with Keith Reeser. Keith Reeser, the cornerback for the Orlando Apollos, as you see here making a pick six. He's had three interceptions this year. He's allowed just 8 receptions on 22 targets for 78 yards. He is incredibly good in coverage, and a lot of NFL teams are going to be looking for him. He is the best cornerback in the Alliance of American Football at the midseason. At safety, we have Commander's safety, Deron Smith. He has been incredible in coverage and caused many problems for offenses in this league. He has 2 interceptions and a pick 6. He is the best safety in the AAF. At linebacker, we have the Orlando Apollo, Terrence Garvin. He has had 3 interceptions and 14 tackles at the halfway mark. Terrence Garvin has definitely made a name for himself, being able to stop the run and the pass on defense. Carter Schult is our defensive end. He has had 18 total tackles, 10 tackles for loss, and 5 sacks, which leads the league. He also has 14 quarterback hits. He has been one of the greatest stories of the AAF and is definitely making a name for himself in Salt Lake City. At defensive tackle or interior defensive lineman, we have chosen Beniquez Brown, who has 32 tackles, 2 sacks, and 1 fumble recovered. He has been vital to this strong defensive line of the Birmingham Iron and is definitely making a name for himself as one of the premier defensive linemen in the Alliance of American Football. Colton Schmidt is your top punter. He is averaging 45 yards per punt, and in a single game in week 3, he had 5 punts marked inside the 20-yard line. He has definitely helped the Iron with the field position battle. At kicker, we have Youngway Koo, who is 11 for 11 on the season. He also scored the first points in Alliance history. He won a game last week against Memphis and has proved to be one of Atlanta's best players. At punt returner, we have Fleet Ron Brooks. He has the lone punt return for a touchdown in the AAF. He's also 30 years old and plays pretty good defense for the Fleet. Let's switch gears to offense. Coming in at quarterback, we have possibly the best player in this league. Depends on who you ask, if you like Keith Reeser or not. Garrett Gilbert at quarterback, 1,357 yards passing, 62.8% completion percentage, 8 total passing touchdowns and no interceptions. He has had a field day so far in this Alliance. He has had a field day so far in the Alliance of American Football and is making a name for himself. At wide receiver, we have Rashad Ross, 401 total yards, 6 touchdowns. He has been the biggest deep threat in the Alliance of American Football, in my opinion. He has had multiple 50-yard touchdowns. He is incredible. You see him making that one-hand catch. He is a great weapon for the Arizona offense. The MVP for the tight end position will go to Nick Truesdale. He has had 114 yards and 2 touchdowns and has been an incredible weapon for the Salt Lake City offense. The next award will be given to the best offensive line. That goes to Orlando, a team that has been able to run, pass, and score at will with an incredible offensive line to protect Garrett Gilbert and those running backs. Kenneth Farrow is one of the most consistent rushers in the AAF. He has 305 yards, 3 touchdowns, and has helped elevate this Commander's offense. Thank you for the support. Make sure to like, subscribe, and comment. Also hit that bell for notifications for when new videos come out. Make sure to comment what type of videos you want to see in the future in the upcoming weeks of the Alliance of American Football.